James, I noticed in a lot of the comments in some of our recent videos regarding the EZE situation that people were saying that at the meeting when EZE signed off the rights for Dre and DOC, some talked about how on Vlad you previously said that it was Jerry Heller, and it wasn't EZE. I know Reggie said on a recent segment that it was easy. I was wondering if you could elaborate on that and kind of just set the record straight one final time, what it was and what happened.
The day that we went to Eazy-E and Jerry Heller's office, we went there solely to talk to Jerry Heller or Eazy about Missy Elliott and Dre's contract. Eazy-E wasn't there. Jerry Heller was there in his office. Now let me give you a little rundown on the office if everybody or whoever been there and who what's called them. We walked through the front door. You go to the right, all the way down the end, is Jerry Heller's office. We went to Jerry Heller, Suge went in the room, closed the door with Jerry. That was what we did. I wasn't there when Suge supposed to got with Easy or something like that. I wasn't there for that. Easy was not at the office, and I said this more than one time. He was not at the office when we went and Suge had the conversation with Jerry Heller. We went to Ruthless Records, and that's when Suge supposed the got Jerry's the contracts for Drano. And we only went at, well, let me say, I only went that one time when it was necessary.
So, to be honest, that's what people are saying in the comment section. For some reason that they got the impression, and some people got the impression that you were there and they were correcting me and John or the video that was stated that you were there when Easy signed over the rights.
No.
And apparently you corrected that. I'm going to give Mike Klein, who was the head of Ruthless Records, business affairs slash security on the phone, because I know we did an interview, a live stream with him recently, and he has set the record straight. And the only reason I'm doing this, me and Jack, because this is a big part of hip hop history, this incident, in my opinion.
Okay.
And I wanted the record to be straight for the final thing, because I may have put out some things that was inaccurate, some things may have been some misunderstandings.
It wasn't even Death Row Records then. It was, Suge was about to launch Death Row. We were still doing Fernhill Records at that time.
Okay. And yeah. So I'll get from straight from the horse with two guys that was there.
Yeah.
James there at a time. I know Mike from talking to Mike before. When Easy signed off, I think it was happened at Solo Records. And it's good to hear that you saying that you weren't even there when that.
Well, if he know.
Hold
he
on.
Know Easy.
I haven't called him yet.
Kept, okay.
I haven't called him.
No, let me explain it.
I'm just trying to think so because we don't
when
care.
When we came, Easy had an office there too. But Easy clowned because his main office was home and all of his contracts, paperwork, he had at home. Okay. And that's why you think he say Dre Day made Easy Day, because they never got nothing from Easy.
Okay. Let me get Mike on the phone.
Okay.
Call Mike. And then y'all can go back and forth to talk about
it.
Because some things that I done said, some things that's been put out there has been put said in you and Mike words incorrectly. And when I know both of y'all, can get to both of y'all.
We're just talking two different times.
Let y'all talk about it.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna call Mike Klein right quick. Mike Klein.
Yes.
How you doing, sir? You on the
good, buddy, how are you?
Good. I hate to call you out the blue again, but it's me and John on Bomb First, and appreciate you coming back to do this little interview for us. We're going to get you on camera one day, but I know you're not one for the cameras, so we're going to just put a beautiful picture of you up so people know who you are once again. But I'm sitting here with James McDonald, and we're doing some taping of some episodes, and I know there was a couple of recent episodes put up in the last week where we talked about the Easy and the Ruthless and the Solar Records and all of that stuff, the incident with Easy. And I just want you both to to talk about it, and you explained, James already explained his, as he recalled, and if you could explain how you know it to be.
I heard what he says, and I can say what James said was correct in the point where Jerry gave contracts. That's before I was involved or my guys were involved.
Okay.
It did happen where Jerry gave contracts, and also Ruthless Records lawyer Ira Selsky gave contracts. That was before I was involved. The only time that we had any interaction with Shug when I was involved is when I first got involved. He came in, we talked to him, he only came there with a woman that he came with, I don't know who she was. And we had a talk, we had an understanding of what was gonna be or what not gonna be. It was one other time that Shug came in with five other people when I was involved. But at that time, nobody went into Jerry's office, nobody went into anybody's office. They were stopped at the door. So I think what James is talking about is prior to me, when Big Man, Charles, and a few other people were there, and they were afraid of Shug and whoever he brought in, and Jerry did give contracts to Shug in his office. That was prior to me getting involved.
Was this 89?
So that's the only thing I can think of that correlates with what James is saying, because Jerry did give agreements to Shug, and so did this guy, lawyer Ira Selsky. They gave agreements to Shug. So that the only thing that meets that criteria is that when I was involved, Shug came there twice. Okay, once Jerry called him, he did not know I was there with my guys. He came in, we had a word, and then another time he came in with five guys, but he didn't make it into Jerry's office. He made it to the front, and that was as far as that goes. So the only thing that makes sense, what James is saying, is at one point, yes, Shug came in. Shug came there quite a few times, but at one time he did come, and Jerry did give him agreements.
Let's put a time frame. Signed. Can you hear me?
He wants to know, Mike, yes, if you can say the year that happened. I think he's thinking this happened in 1989.
No, I believe the first time when we went, because we still was doing Fernhill.
Okay.
And when Shug was putting his plan together, I believe it started 89. We were still with Tom Klein. So
that would make a lot of sense, because yeah, I didn't get involved until 91.
Oh yeah, way before your time. Way before your time.
I didn't get involved until 91. After all this happened to Jerry and to Easy, that's when they called me. But prior to that, they were terrified, I have to tell you. You guys scared the hell out of them. Jerry, not Easy, but Jerry.
No, Easy, see, and people get it twisted, because Eazy-E did a lot of his work from home.
Yeah.
A lot of his business was
work.
Huh?
Out of Norwalk.
Yeah, so when Shug went in there and talked to Jerry, there was no Eazy. I want the people to understand, there was no Eazy. This was around 89, because when did Death Row start?
Death Row didn't start until like 91.
Okay, 90, Death Row didn't exist in
92.
Well, the first album came out in 92.
Yeah. But Death Row didn't start that until, because we was putting shit together at the time. So this was around 89. I was fresh out of prison. I got out in 88. Around end of 88, 89 is when that happened.
Let me ask y'all this, both of y'all.
That makes sense, James.
Okay.
That makes sense, because from what I heard too from Jerry, he said she came there many times with people. He was terrified, and he told me he gave agreements. And so did Ira Selsky, a lawyer. Shug went up to his office,
right,
and got contracts from him too. So that did happen. It didn't happen. guys were there. Shook did come there once with four or five guys when my guys were there, but he didn't make it through. He did stop them at the lobby. But I, what he's telling me at the time frame, that would have been big man, big guy was there, James.
It was three. He has three guards there.
Okay, so he had, so it had to be big man Charles and somebody else that Easy had as security beside the twins. The twins were usually at the No Walk House with them. So he had other guys with them, and they were all terrified of choking you guys.
Let me ask you this, Mike. This is something that a lot of people put in the comments. I don't know where they heard it, where they saw it from, but there were some allegations that the only reason and the main reason that Eazy-E signed off on the paperwork was because Suge Knight threatened Eazy-E's mother by showing his address or something like that. When did that allegedly happen? Yes.
And they knew where his mother lived.
Yes.
So that's what I was told, and that's what Easy told me.
Now, when was
nobody
that?
Nobody laid a hand on him.
Yes.
That was 91.
The Jerry I saw that Suge went in the office with, he was hoping, it was like somebody closed the casket door on his ass. He didn't want to be in there by himself. He didn't want to be in there with Suge.
And I met him. He couldn't stop shaking.
His security didn't do shit.
Yeah, they're not professional. They were friends of Easy. They're not professional security guys. There was guy, big man, Charles, and another guy that he had. And then he had the twins.
Well, I'm glad. I'm glad y'all weren't there.
Those guys, they took him shooting. They couldn't hit the target.
Did you hear what Jay said, Mike?
What?
He said he glad you guys went there. He just said he glad you guys went there.
Because all I had was a little bitty ass 25.
When my guys were there, and this has been a long time.
I know karate though.
I had guys on the roof. These are all, every one of my guys, not for show guys, not Animal, Mike, or Robert, or the other guys. They were guys for size and show, and they were tough guys. But my guys were all special forces guys, every one of them. Combat, and now terrorists. So, I mean, we had security where security couldn't be seen, but we didn't ever have to use it or do anything. I think once me and Shook sat down, and just for the clarifications, so everybody knows, today, me and Sugar are good friends. I talk to him just about every day.
Exactly.
So, we started on the opposite side, but, we just wanted to do our job, and just, I don't know if James knows, but those releases that Easy signed were worthless. And the only reason Jimmy Iovine did a deal with Suge is after he called us and approached us and said, I'm not sure that James is familiar with the history. When I got involved, I didn't just get involved with security. I got four of the best lawyers out there. You know one of them, Reggie, Richard Sherman.
Yes.
And they sent letters to everybody in the industry saying to them that those releases were done under duress, they're meaningless, and we filed lawsuits at that time against Sony, Dick Griffey, Suge, Trey, and everybody involved. We also sent everybody letters saying if anybody would do any business with Trey, they would be sued for interference with contractual agreement. Nobody would touch Trey. Nobody would do anything. Jimmy called us and said, listen, I would like to distribute him. We can work out a deal. And there was two options for us to do. Either keep Dre from not doing anything for the next 6-7 years, or do a business deal. And we made business decision. It was best for Dre to do his own stuff and Easy and the Ruthless Records would benefit from it, and that's what happened.
And by benefiting, you mean the money that they got directly from Interscope?
Anything that Dre did, produce, acted on, any other arts that he produced, we got a percentage of.
Right.
Not only from, did we get a percentage of, we got a bunch of money from Interscope up front.
From Interscope, okay, gotcha.
From Interscope. And then we had to go back to Jimmy, because we felt that some of the stuff that Dr. Dre was doing was not credited to him to avoid paying us. So I met with Jimmy and told him which way was up and which way was down, and he immediately paid us money.
That's Jimmy. Jimmy will cut a check and make a problem go away.
He dotted his I's and crossed his T's.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what Mike Kine's saying, and that's why I always get mad when they call him security.
I'm going to call Mike and talk to Mike.
He's business affairs. Oh, that's going to be the attorney. Mike control. I told you, we got people in place that and we're going to be making that conversation, because Mike has been a great friend of mine in the recent time with helping with things, and he's been helping Shug, I know of, for the last 5 to 6 years.
Okay.
And there's somebody else that dear and close that most people would be surprised to know that Mike Kine has helped out.
Okay.
From the Nation of Islam, and he has helped him.
I helped. Listen, I've helped a lot of people out.
Yes.
And that's what I do. Even though me and Shug were on the opposite side, I was the one that got him lawyers when he got in trouble.
That night, with Terry Carter.
With Terry Carter, that was the first one he called.
Exactly.
Lawyers.
Exactly.
If he would have stayed with my lawyers, he'd be out today. But he didn't listen.
Yeah. Well, that's Shug. Mike Kine.
James, nice meeting you.
You too.
Thank you, Mike, for taking the time to set the record straight.
Absolutely. Absolutely, guys. Take care of yourself. And stay out of trouble, both of you.
Yes,
and they sound like you the one that's out of trouble.
Listen, we're all getting older over here. We don't need any problems.
That's right.
Respect, Mike.
And take care, buddy.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye-bye.
So, bomb first. The only reason we're here, and we reiterated this situation again, because number one, James McDonald and Reggie Wright have a lot of respect for Eazy-E and what he did for the city of Compton and for hip hop. And so we're not here trying to make Eazy-E and Ruthless Records look under, worse, and putting Death Row on a higher pedestal. That's for you guys to decide what music you like or don't like. We're here just to set the record straight, and that's all we're trying to do.
That's it.
Peace. Hold on.